a possible new drug breakthrough to treat COVID-19.
That's right. WGN medical reporter Dina Baer explains how it works.
One of the most prevalent complications in COVID-19 patients is blood clots. And now, a lifetime of research on a protein that impacts clotting could hold the key to halt clots after a COVID diagnosis.
I've been interested in a protein that is involved in the control of the clot dissolving system in the blood for a long time.
For more than 30 years, Northwestern Medicine's Dr. Douglas Vaughn has studied plasminogen activator inhibitor type 1, or PI-1 for short. It's a protein we naturally make in our bodies, but it actually inhibits our ability to dissolve a blood clot.
We want our clot dissolving system to work. We really have three internal systems that help keep us from clotting inside our blood vessels.
PI-1 blocks them all. When COVID-19 hit, Dr. Vaughn took note of a life-threatening complication, particularly among older patients, those who are overweight, and people with high blood pressure or diabetes, blood clots.
Clotting, not just in the lung, but in the heart, in the kidney, in the brain, is a major contributor to trouble when somebody has COVID-19. We think that PI-1 is a suspicious candidate in contributing to that clotting problem that's systemic.
To test their theory, Dr. Vaughn and his team measured the level of PI-1 in 34 COVID-19 patients at Northwestern Memorial Hospital. Their findings were off the chart.
We've measured PI-1 in 34 patients that have been hospitalized here at Northwestern. They have astronomically high levels of PI-1. I've been measuring it for over 20 years in my laboratory, measured it in thousands of patients. The average level of PI-1 in a COVID patient is 10 times normal. And we've seen it as high as 50 times normal in some of our patients. I've never seen anything like it. It's a pretty rational target to think about.
Thankfully, the researchers already had a drug in the works, one that reduces PI-1 levels by 50 to 60%.
PI-1 is increased by inflammation. Our COVID patients are very, very inflamed systemically. PI-1 is driven by low oxygen, and a lot of our COVID patients have problems with oxygenating their blood.
The research team was granted fast-track status by the FDA and is ready to enroll patients in their drug study as early as Monday.
I lay awake at night and think about it a little bit. Sometimes the situation finds you instead of you finding it. It created a clinical opportunity to test a hypothesis that could have a positive impact on patients that are hospitalized with the disease.
The experimental drug is already in early clinical trials in Japan, where so far it appears to be safe for patients. Back to you.